It's such a pleasure to make your acquaintance, Chris, especially because you represent the Space Force.
The Space Force. It is a real thing. It is a thing. Six branch created on 20 September 2019. Right now, by far the smallest branch, but the newest, and it is a real thing.
Who populates the branch? How do they get chosen? And what's the mission?
A diverse set of folks, just like any other branch of the military, multicultural, all different types of backgrounds. Right now, primarily, the Space Force consists of other service members from other branches who have transferred into the Space Force. Myself, I was a member of the United States Air Force. And last year, I had the opportunity and I got approved to transfer in to the United States Space Force. And its mission is, like any other military branch, it is to protect and defend the homeland. Here, primarily, it is from space.
And you're local. You grew up in Hawaii. It must be kind of exciting to be part of this new vision, I guess, of the United States military.
Yes, born and raised here in Hawaii. Graduated from Waipawa High School, class of 2003. A lot of things had to fall into place for me to ultimately get stationed back here at home. Count my blessings, been great, and looking forward to the next, iteration of what, where my service will take me. Once again, just grateful to be part of it.
And I would imagine being part of the Space Force, which is the open space, it's sort of like your life.
I would have never imagined years ago that I'd be sitting here right now in this uniform, being able to establish the new culture of this branch, right, the newest branch of the military, being able to facilitate, integrate space operations in the way we fight, the way we defend, the way we protect the homeland in, through, and from space.
And I would imagine it's challenging, as well as quite interesting, to have members from all different branches of the United States military in one location.
Different perspectives from the other branches, from the other folks, part of the Space Force, holistically builds, where we want to take the force in the future.
What's next for the Space Force besides protection? Is there research involved? Is there exploration?
Yes, absolutely. Research here in Hawaii, we have the Maui Telescope. We have a research and development laboratory out there. On Oahu, we have the Kainoa Point tracking station out there. And then just internally within the organization, restructuring, taking all of our Space Force service members, our guardians, reallocating them, developing a new organization to best integrate space operations here to protect Hawaii, to protect the homeland.
What preparation is necessary to be part of this force?
Space is hard. It is an extremely challenging, extremely unforgiving domain to operate in, to operate through. Some of the background, some of the experiences, some of the preparation, the training that goes into it, heavy STEM background, science, technology, engineering, mathematics. Myself, my experiences, heavy in the space operations side, satellite maneuvers, how satellite constellations operate, the health monitoring, telemetry, tracking, controlling of those satellites. But it does speak to the challenge that domain does avail to.
Well, and there must be a requirement for those entering the Space Force to have an open mind, a willing heart to consider what's not even known yet.
We do have that coolness factor, right? The United States Space Force. Space is really ingrained in our culture, if you really think about it, in U.S. culture. So definitely helps from that aspect. Right now, primarily space operations background for folks, intelligence, engineering, acquisitions, cyberspace, those type of backgrounds. Plus, you figure, the culture effect that space already has on all of us.
So it's grounded in the sciences and it's grounded in information.
Absolutely, it is grounded in science. Like I said, space is hard. It is extremely challenging.
Thank you for being with us and helping us share more about space.
Thank you, Lila.
Thank you for listening to my conversation with Senior Master Sergeant Kristopher-Michael Kainoa with the U.S. Space Force.